following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
I'm glad you're here on time, because we were just going to go up Sesame Street. I fixed up Sesame Street differently. Let's see if you can figure out what I did. Let's go. All right.
Dishes.
Dishes? You're right. Dishes is right.
Empty.
Yeah, what's supposed to be in place of dishes?
Newspapers.
Newspapers. Good. Let's go. All right. Let's go ahead and go next. All right, check further up. What?
Chairs.
What about these chairs?
They're upside down.
They sure are upside down. All right. What else we got?
A stocking.
Stocking it is. Look at that stuff.
Christmas.
That's a Christmas stocking, but there's nothing in it by now, huh?
I thought it was a whole bunch of.
Yeah. Fooled you, huh? All right. Let's go.
The pump.
What about that pump? Look what we got here.
It has some mittens.
Mittens?
Some beard. And
look at that
cap.
Beard. Yes, huh? That's an interesting hat, isn't it? Belongs to me. Who else?
A lizard.
Oh, I didn't put that there. What's that doing there?
Oh, I put it there, Mr. Hooper.
Oh, Bob.
Sure. How do you like that lizard?
Well, that's an interesting lizard. Look how shiny it is.
Mm-hmm. Huh? He was just in having a chocolate sundae with Susan a few minutes ago. And he said he wanted to come out and sit on the front steps for a while.
What time of the day was that?
Well, I wouldn't want to. Just a few minutes ago.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a tegu lizard. You know
what is that? Oh, there it is.
What?
A bee, there.
Oh,
where?
I see it.
Yeah, there it is. How do you like that?
Yeah, it's pretty.
Do you know what it is?
No, it's a lizard.
It's a lizard, right. You know where he comes from?
Africa.
No, not Africa. It's a good guess. Mm-hmm. This one comes from South America.
South America.
It's called a tegu lizard.
Tegu?
Tegu, mm-hmm. What does lizard rhyme with?
Pizzard.
Wizard? Lizard?
I'll take gizzard.
Gizzard? That's a rhyming word.
Wizard.
Take a
wizard.
Guess. Take a guess about how big this lizard is going to get when he's full grown.
16 feet?
No, not that big. That's about as big as an alligator or something like that.
Oh.
This one gets about 4.5 feet long, which about is...
Get ready to say
that's about as tall as you, right?
I almost said 3. 3?
Well, you were close. He gets to be about 4.5 feet long. Hey, you know what I found a few minutes ago?
What? Skin.
I found some of his skin right here. Can you see it?
Oh, yeah.
He sheds
skin. It's got lines.
Yeah, it has little lines. It's very, very
I've seen a snake with that kind of lines.
Sheds snakes? Yeah. Snakes shed their skins too, don't they? Like lizards?
I went to the museum and the boy had a lot of skin.
The boy had a lot of skin?
Of snake.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Did he make a...
6 pieces.
6 pieces? Wow. This piece came right off the back of his tail, right in there that was on.
I like those toes.
Those toes, yeah. Oh, and you know he's got a long, long tongue. I don't know if we can get him to put it out or not. Can you see his tongue coming
out?
Yeah. He catches insects and
it's
things
a
like that.
Tongue.
A forked tongue, right.
Yes.
Like, it's sticky and they catch little insects on it. It's one of the ways they catch their food.
Hi there. Once again, it is me, the world's smartest frog, to talk to you about another groovy word. And today's groovy word is the word round, okay? The word today is round. Now, I'd like to show you what round is. Unfortunately, there's nothing round around here. Hey, you guys, send in something round, would you? Okay, now that is perfect, because now we have a ball. And a ball, as you can all plainly tell, is a nice round shape. See, it's all sort of nice and even and curved and sort of like a circle, you know? Now, because a ball is round, it can roll, and it can spin, and it can bounce.
And it can sing tiptoe through the tulips.
And it can sing tiptoe through the, wait a minute, who said that? Hold on here.
What's the matter? You'd rather hear old MacDonald had a farm?
No, I would not. Now, you, sir, are a rubber ball.
So?
Well, rubber balls can't talk.
Neither can frogs.
Well, I don't really know what to say to that.
Just continue the lesson, old froggy teacher of mine.
Okay.
Okay.
As I was saying now, a ball is round, so it can roll.
You betcha we can.
Oh, that's very good.
Yeah, thank you.
And not only can a ball roll, but it can also spin. Very good spinning, ball. Okay, not only can a ball spin and roll, but the ball can also bounce.
Yeah, and the ball can also sing tiptoe through the tulips, through the tulips.
Wait a minute, hold it, you.
What?
Now listen, rubber balls aren't supposed to sing.
Oh, yeah? Tell that to my brother. He was a big recording star.
I don't believe it.
Yeah, he was until a truck ran over him and squashed him out of shape.
Oh?
Yeah, now he's a football for the Green Bay Packers.
How will you stop that? Now just cut that out.
Hey, I got a lot of relatives, you know? Yeah, my Uncle Louie gained a lot of weight and became a bowling ball. And I've got a flock of little cousins who are Christmas tree ornaments.
Listen, you, come on now. I don't want to even hear about your relatives. Well, listen, stop that bouncing and come back here and sit down.
Oh, I like
or
that.
I'm going to flatten you against the wall.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi there, son.
Hey, Dad, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine. Now, where'd he go?
Who was he, boy?
A frog. I was just talking to him a minute ago.
Oh, don't be silly, son. Frogs can't talk.
Yeah, I guess he's right.
Now, these are both round, right? So they're the same exact shape, but they're not the same size. This one's big, and this one's little. Now, if I draw a face on here, like this, big face, and a little face, this could be the mother circle, and this could be the baby circle. A mother and her baby.
Looks good as the mother bird is about to have a baby. Look how all the birds just sit around and wait for their babies.
Uh-oh, baby.
What they doing? What is that cat doing?
Uh-oh, drinking some milk. A cow.
Mother's feeding her, see?
Baby lion.
Yep. They're all drinking milk.
Drinking milk from his mother.
Right. Look at her. What's she doing?
Want me to wash his ears? Oh, no.
And the lioness? Now look how they clean.
Great kangaroo.
What's she doing? Washing his ears?
Yeah.
Do baby kangaroos carry babies in their pouches?
Mm-mm.
What they doing, having a piggyback?
A baby kitten.
They have a lot of ways to take care of their babies, mm-hmm. don't they, Scooter?
Baby hippo.
You know that hippopotamus is bigger than you. Now look at him.
Fighting it.
And that's like you and your brother when y'all get to fighting. Look, he's sucking his finger.
Well, sucking his thumb.
Some babies look just like their mother, only not so tall. Look how graceful that swan is. Just swims
along. Oh, wow, look at that little duck.
See that little baby swan?
Uh-huh.
It'll have to grow before it can look like its mother.
Oh, no, look at that baby one.
But all babies know exactly who their mothers are.
Q!
And now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is my great honor to present to you the world's greatest counter of numbers. This great counter will attempt the incredible feat of counting to 10.
Hey, Ernie. Hey, what you doing, Ernie?
Well, I'm announcing the world's greatest counter of numbers. See, he's going to count to 10 right before your very eyes.
And who, pray tell, is the world's greatest counter of numbers?
Me.
You?
Yep. You want to hear me count to 10?
Sure. What have I got to lose?
Okay, here we go. One. Two. Three. Pretty good so far, huh, Bert?
Oh, just fine, fine, yeah.
Okay. One. Two.
Uh-huh.
Three. I bet you didn't think I could get this far, huh, Bert?
Just keep counting, Ernie. Come on now.
Okay. One.
What?
Two. Three.
Ernie?
What?
Now look, why do you keep starting over? I mean, why don't you just continue from where you left off?
Well, I lose my place, Bert. You know, I mean, if somebody interrupts me, I have to start all over again.
And that's what you're going to do right now, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right, Ernie? You're going to start all over again, right?
You bet. One.
One.
Two. Three.
Ernie,
was that you growling, Bert?
Yes, that was me.
I thought so. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. God bless you.
Thank you.
One. Two. Three, four. Did you say something, Bert?
No, nothing. No. Go ahead.
Oh, sorry. One.
One.
Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. in.
At last.
Thank you, friends. Thank you. Thank you. Wasn't that great?
I'm just glad you're through, that's all.
Oh, yes, I'm through. And now I'm going to recite the alphabet. A. B. C.
I can't stand it.
Please, Bert, don't interrupt. I'm doing the alphabet. A. B. C. D. E. F. G. H.
95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100. Ready or not, here I come. What's with your mata? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Hey, Ronald's really pretty good at finding people. But you know, I know one guy he could never find. Because no one can ever find Roosevelt Franklin. Thursday?
No, wait a minute now.
Wait a minute. If you don't know the days of the week, all we have to do is ask somebody that knows. And I know somebody that knows Roosevelt Franklin.
Yeah, Roosevelt!
Wait a minute. There he goes now. Call him.
Unless I heard somebody wrong, somebody call me by both my names, my first name first, and then my second name second.
Yes, Roosevelt, we don't know the days of the week, and we know you know.
Well, scooby-doo-doo-doo-doo, I make a deal with you. I tell you the days of the week. If you get together and get me a plate of string beans, because you know I dig me some string beans.
Well, I'll pick and I'll step on the walk. I'll cook them.
Now, I'll eat them. Now, if you want to hear the days of the week, girl, get yourself together and listen. It was early Monday morning, I was on my way to school.
Monday morning.
Uh-huh.
Monday morning.
It was early Monday morning, I was on my way to school.
Monday morning.
Well.
Monday morning.
Went to study my lesson so I wouldn't be nobody's fool.
Monday morning. Monday morning.
Ooh, Roosevelt, you sure had a smile.
I got off to a good start. I woke up Tuesday morning and I ate my grits and eggs.
Tuesday morning, Tuesday morning.
Woke up Tuesday morning and I ate my grits and eggs.
Tuesday morning, Tuesday morning.
I put shoes on my feet, but first I put socks on my legs.
Tuesday morning, Tuesday morning.
Then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, I was in school every day. In school every day.
Wednesday, Thursday, Thursday, Friday.
I go 5 times a week, I get 5 times smarter that way.
Wednesday, Thursday, Thursday, Friday.
And you sure are smart too.
Watch this, it's the weekend. Saturday and Sunday, Roosevelt Franklin can play. Franklin can play.
Sunday.
Because I know the name of each and every day.
Sunday.
See, I know Monday.
Monday.
And I know Tuesday.
Tuesday.
I also know Wednesday.
Wednesday.
And then I know Thursday. Plus I know Friday.
Friday.
I also know Saturday.
Saturday.
And I know Sunday. Cause I'm Roosevelt Franklin. Because I'm Roosevelt Franklin.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I said I'm Roosevelt Franklin.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Call me Roosevelt Franklin.
Yeah, yeah.
Eight. ached. Never mind about the eight.
It's a parrot.
What do you think it is, Ronald?
A parrot.
A parrot? You're very, very close. It's in the parrot family. What do you think it is, girls? It looks like a parrot, doesn't it? Because it has beautiful feathers all over.
And the stripes.
Mm-hmm.
What's the stripes for?
It's called a macaw.
Oh, what's the stripes for?
Well, the stripes are part of his, you know, plumage, his feathers, used for camouflaging him with, oh, look at him ruffle his feathers, huh? Isn't that pretty? This is a macaw. Tell me what a macaw looks like. You ever been this close to a macaw? Looks like a parrot. Tell me something else about him.
Has a long tail.
Has a long tail.
Has colored feathers.
Colored feathers. What colors are they?
Green, blue,
mm-hmm.
and red.
Mm-hmm.
Blue, green, and red.
What about his bill? What's that look like?
White.
It's white. It's kind of long and sharp, isn't it?
Yeah, the bottom.
You know what he can...
Where's his teeth?
Well, he really... I don't know. You don't see any teeth there, really, do you? See, look at his tongue. That's really...
It looks like a worm
when it comes out.
Yeah. He can crack things with that bill. Nuts, right. You're absolutely right. It's nice and sharp. He can crack them open with his bill, and he can take the meat of a nut right out of the shell with his tongue.
He was scratching his beak.
He's scratching his beak?
Could he walk across the state?
He could, yeah. But I don't think he wants to right now.
He wants to sit there all day.
Yeah.
Till tomorrow.
He's got toes in the front and toes in the back, so he can hang on, he can close,
why
climb.
Why is his feet straight out like this?
Because he can do all kinds of things. Hey, listen, you know what? We've had a great time being here today, right?
Right.
Except I don't know about Mr. Hooper, because he had a pretty rough time with that number 8 and his letter Q.
And the
lizard, right. But we've got to go. We'll be here. You come back and see us again, okay?
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters A, Q, and U, and by the numbers 8 and 9. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.